Welcome, fellow Trucksters, Fanboys, and Musketeers, to episode 3 of the Hoosier Cybertruck channel. As I lay my sweet head down to rest each night, visions of the Cybertruck frolic in my mind. One of the things I'm most excited about is how the Cybertruck is going to change how the family and I go camping, which is one of our favorite activities. Hiking, swimming, and ignoring each other while we're on our electronic devices is so much better when you're in the outdoors. However, it's not all roses and rainbows. There is one issue that keeps me up at night, and that is range anxiety. As is the case with any electric vehicle, range is a thing. And when you're towing, range is a really big thing. But as I've tried to rationalize in my head why range won't be an issue with the Cybertruck, I've come to the conclusion that range won't be an issue. Before we get into why I ain't scared, let's level set, get aligned, and other corporate terms meaning having an equal understanding of the facts. For those new to the electric vehicle game, how far you can travel on a single charge is one of the biggest differences between an electric vehicle and an internal combustion engine vehicle. The possibility of running out of juice in your electric vehicle while you're on a road trip is something that you need to be careful of. And while Tesla just opened up their 20,000th supercharger, the number of places where one can go to charge their electric vehicle is far less than a fossil fuel fill-up station. Now let's add into the equation, your electric vehicle is towing a boat, travel trailer, or whatever, and you can cut that range in half. But wait, there's more. Now imagine that you're driving into a strong headwind, or it could be raining or snowing, and your expected range could be even less. And then you are screwed. And now, hopefully you can understand why hundreds of people are diagnosed with range anxiety every day. As I said at the top, glamping is one of our family's favorite activities, and we do it a good bit. We love to visit Indiana's state parks in our 2008 Rockwood Rue hybrid travel trailer. Our camper weighs in at around 4,500 pounds dry, but just to make the math easy, when it's loaded down with gear, food, and all of our stuff, let's assume that it's around 6,000 pounds. All right, last bit of setup. I've reserved a dual motor, full self-driving Cybertruck with a range of around 300 miles when fully charged. So let's be extra conservative, which means that we have around 120 miles of range when we're towing our camper. So that's all the setup. Let's get into what I believe is the magic pill to cure range anxiety. Yeah, you just charge at the campsite. So that should do it for this episode. Thanks everybody for watching. Really appreciate your support. Really though, that's why I think camping at a state park or even a private campground where there's shore power there at the campsite is the cure for range anxiety. In my experience, these power stations will have either a 30 or 50 amp service. And many times there will be both along with the standard outlet. So hypothetically speaking, when we get to the campground, we're all set up, we'll plug in our travel trailer into the 30 amp service, leaving the 50 amp service for the Cybertruck. In the event that the campsite only has 30 amp service, no problem. We'll just switch between plugging the camper in or charging the Cybertruck. If we're going for a hike, going for a bike ride, plug in the Cybertruck and charge it up, man. And best of all, you've already paid for the electricity as part of the fee for the campsite. So there is no additional charge to charge. But there's even another reason why I don't have range anxiety, and it's because of where we like to go camping. All of our favorite campgrounds are less than 100 miles from home. Let's crunch some numbers, shall we? At the top of the list, we've got Paintown at 19 miles, Hardin Ridge is at 21 miles, McCormick's Creek at 23 miles, Brown County at 30 miles, Shackamack at 53 miles, big jump then up to Turkey Run at 84 miles, and then Clifty Falls, which I think might just be our favorite campground, is 94 miles away. And because we'll only be towing around 60% of the dual motors 10,000 pound capacity with our camper, I hope that our range will be even better. Now, this is not to say that I am completely carefree when it comes to towing with the Cybertruck. Some of our favorite places to go camping are up north to Michigan and down south to the Great Smoky Mountains of Tennessee. In another video, I'll go over the scenarios where I do have a bit of range anxiety. I think that's it for this video. Thank you if you've made it this far for watching. Fight me in the comments if you disagree. Show me some love if you agree. In either case, I'll see you truckers later.